Jesus. Saint William of Montvergine, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. We have a very fitting saint today who follows John the Baptist. He, like him, spent most of his life as a solitary, and he began, like our Lord's forerunner, at a very young age. He is an Italian who lived in the 11th century, the 12th century, and at the age of 15, he was barely 15, when he resolved to make a very penitential pilgrimage to Compostela, to go all on foot with chains rubbed, or rather wrapped very tightly around his waist, which was a traditional act of penance, and with many other sacrifices upon the way, he went to Compostela. And that being successful, then he desired to make another pilgrimage to the Holy Land. But he was advised by a priest, St. John of Matera, that was not God's will for him. But still he persisted, and as soon as he set out on his voyage, why then he was beset by robbers. He lost everything. He lost the money to be able to pay for the ship and his food. And so he realized that that was indeed not God's will for him. First lesson of our saint. Sometimes our Lord speaks to us in very clear and very simple terms as to what his divine will for us is. He followed his true life vocation, which was to be first a hermit, like John the Baptist, by himself in the mountain, the wilderness, fasting and praying. And then, after that, it was to have a good effect of preaching to others, again, like John the Baptist. Saint William, by means of his great sanctity and his miracles, which always follow on sanctity, drew followers to himself, almost in spite of himself, and he ended up founding a distinct congregation of Benedictines who followed his particular constitution. Some of the great miracles that he worked included that of, similar to a saint we had last week, that is to say that the monastery mule was eaten by a wolf, and he too tamed the wolf and forced the wolf to take the place of the donkey in helping out for all of the domestic projects around the monastery, and that went on actually for quite some time. The other great miracle that he performed was in connection with his final role as a great advisor to the king, Roger II of Sicily. The king had heard wonderful things about him, but was not sure whether he was genuine or, in an age of so many unworthy and worldly priests, was a fraud. And so he sent a wicked woman to tempt our saint, which was, of course, in itself a terrible thing to do, a sin, but that would show that this king was really in need of godly counsel from a good confessor. And what our saint did was, when the woman came into his room, he went to the great big open fireplace. With his own hand, he moved the burning hot coals all aside, and then he turned towards the big smile and said, "Well, here I am, I'm ready, why don't you come and join me?" And she was so shocked at that miracle that the fire of God's love came into her heart. She repented, went to confession, and passed the rest of her life in penance. She herself became a nun. Well, the word of that came to the king, and then he finished his last days as a great advisor to this king. The monastery that he finally settled on was on a mountain south of Naples called Monte Virgiliano. And the great Latin poet Virgil is said to have written some of his works, including that famous line in which Virgil predicted the coming of our Lord, born of a virgin. And Saint William had the happy idea to change the name of the mountain to Monte Virgine in honor of the Blessed Mother. And to this very day, there are many, many thousands of pilgrims who climb that mountain each day, each year, especially around this time of the year, in honor of the Mother of God. Last thought about today's saint. Another saint whom we have today is Saint Gothard, who is a martyr bishop from the just about the year 800 in the city of Nantes in France. The Normans at that time were Norsemen, and they were invading France from all different directions. and they came, a battalion of ships, up the Seine River to this town that was in the Loire Valley, the town of Nantes, and the bishop and the priests and all of the people had gathered in the cathedral, and they were praying to God for deliverance, and the bishop was actually offering mass when the Norsemen, the Vikings, broke into the cathedral, slew the clergy at the sacred altar, and then slew or enslaved all of the inhabitants of the city who were there in the cathedral. It was an interesting thing for me to note that only about 200 years later, the descendants of those same Norsemen became the Normans. And this Roger II, who had such an esteem for our saint, he was a Norman king. So you see how it is in God's plan that those who are your persecutors today may, in due time, become your beneficiaries. You never know how the divine providence will work. And it's one of the comforting truths of reading a little history to see how God's plan is so often fulfilled throughout the ages. So it fills us with confidence, even for our own age, which we seem to be indeed surrounded by barbarians. Let us ask St. William of Montevergine to give us the grace, regardless of how busy we are, to keep a little solitude in our lives, to keep a little balance, too, as we view the bad news of the day. Who knows? God, by events, may show us his holy will, and certainly his will triumph in the end. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.